What we have now is a systematic way of computing the QR factorization by recognizing it to be the same as the Gram-Schmidt process. But if I asked you to now give me an algorithm using the flame notation, you would be kind of at a loss. So let me show you how the flame notation allows us to very elegantly state the same QR factorization algorithm. And notice that our matrix A consisted of columns, and therefore we probably want to march through our matrix A from left to right, exposing columns. Similarly, we were computing the columns of Q one column at a time, and therefore we probably want to march through Q by columns. The matrix R is an upper triangular matrix, and it's always convenient to partition an upper triangular matrix into a 3x3 partitioning, or rather 2x2 partitioning that tracks the quadrants and that then exposes a 3x3 partitioning as we slide through the matrix. So let's partition as such, and let's see what comes out. Well, when we partition matrices, often the next thing that we do is to multiply partitioned matrices together. So let's multiply these together. So on the left, we continue with our A0, A1, A2. And notice that if we multiply the Q times R, we must retain the equality. And what do you get? When you do partitioned matrix-matrix multiply, you get the Q0 times R0, 0, plus Q1 times 0, plus Q2 times 0. So this part of the matrix is just Q0 times R0, 0. If we now look at this second column, it equals this times that plus that times that plus that times 0. So that gives us this right here. And finally, the last part of the matrix here must equal this times that plus that times that plus that times that. And that's stated right here. So here we restate it, and what we notice that is that A0 must be equal to Q0 R0 0. A1 must be equal to Q0 R0 1 plus rho 1 1 Q1. And A2 must be equal to this mess right here. Now, we're going to assume that we've already processed all of these columns, where we took the first however many columns and we computed its QR factorization. So far we have done the Gram-Schmidt process with all of the columns up to the stick line. The question now is how to move forward. Well, we know that this has to equal to that. So let's write that right here. We can multiply both sides by Q0 transpose. That gives us this. Equality does not change if you multiply both sides by the same matrix from the left. If we then distribute Q0 and recognize that a scalar can always be brought out front, we get this right here. But notice that this is just the identity, and notice that this here is the vector that you get by taking the columns of Q0 and taking dot products of those columns with Q1. But all of the columns in Q0 we want to be orthogonal to Q1, so that term disappears. And what you end up with is a vector R01 that you can compute by multiplying A1 by Q0 transpose. We've seen this somewhere before. Where have we seen this? We saw that all of these coefficients that we encounter in the Gram-Schmidt process could all be computed as one vector, which was this matrix right here, which we could call Q0 transpose, multiplying AK. And I think I even at that point said, we could call that vector R01. So that's exactly what justifies how we just computed R01. So notice that we know Q0, we know A1, so we can now compute this vector R01 which is part of the next column of R. So now let's go back to this equation right here. And now we know A1, we know Q0, we know R01. We would like to compute these. This here is actually the component of A1 orthogonal to the column space of Q0. So that's just A1 perp. And then all we need to do is compute the length of A1 perp and divide A1 perp by that length. And we have computed our next column of Q. So if we put that all together into an algorithm, we get this right here. Here are the steps. Compute all of the scalars that we encountered in the Gram-Schmidt process in one go as a matrix vector multiply. Compute the component of A1 orthogonal to the columns of Q0. Notice that this right here is equal to A1 minus Q0. And if we now plug in what R01 is, we get Q0 transpose A1. And this is exactly the component of A1 in the column space of Q0. And subtracting that off then leaves us with the component that's orthogonal to that. Then we compute the length, and we divide by the length. And in the process, little by little, we compute the columns of Q and the columns of R. Implicitly, everything below the diagonal here is equal to 0.